Okay, good afternoon, everyone. For today, we are going to discuss one of the emerging skills that we need to develop. And I do believe that you already know about this because in your Canvas, this is one of your assignments last meeting. So let's have a check here. Who already accomplished your assignments in Canvas? Can you raise your hands? Okay, so I think it's not something I'm familiar already about the forces of 21st century learning. And let's go to have a deep dive regarding this topic. But before anything else, let me present to you my big question. How might we use Google Doc to hone the forces of 21st century learning of students? So this is our big idea for today's session. Now, since you already raised your hand a while back, we already know about forces. So what are the forces based on your assignment in Canvas? One? Give me one C. Yes, Chadloy?
Communication.
Okay.
Critical thinking.
Very good. Critical thinking. What else? Creativity, very good. And the last one? Collaboration. So let's try to have a deep dive regarding these forces. So before anything else, let's try to ponder on this question. Why are 21st century skills so important? Are you familiar with this term, 21st century? We are now living in the 21st century. So why is it that it's necessary for us to have 21st century skills? So this is one of the main reasons. So if you try to look at, this is actually a workforce requirement survey result. The source of that is, are they really ready to work? It's a report of the Conference Board 21 FL. What does the result says? These are the following skills that the industry partners need to a particular person who is applying for a job. So for example, you are all future teachers and you are going to apply for a teaching position. And these are the common skills that you need to have as an entry level when you will get hired. So you notice on these applied skills, do you think that the C's that you mentioned a while back is reflected on our survey? Do you think our first C's of 21st century? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, exactly. The four C's are present in all the survey, conducted, meaning that the first C's is relevant in the 21st century. So what is forces of 21st century learning? Again, these are our assignments. These are the collaboration, communication, creativity, and critical thinking. So why the forces? A focus on collaboration, communication, creativity, and critical thinking is essential to prepare students for increasingly complex life and work environments in the 21st century. And let's start with the collaboration. For the next 3 weeks, based on your syllabus, we are going to tackle what are the relevant tools on the courses. So on collaboration, let's see collaboration. It occurs when two or more people work together to accomplish a shared and common goal. So you know, in a workforce, collaboration is important. When you will become teacher someday, collaboration will be important because there are opportunities that you will be designing output, a material, you are going to organize an event. I think that our leaders are here, they can already experience that one. We need collaboration, okay? So how to build collaboration skills? Can you repeat? The first one, Angelo?
Work effectively in different groups.
very clear. Regardless of the person, who is the person, we need to work together. What else? Can you read the second one?
Be flexible and willing to compromise with team members to reach a common goal.
Okay, very good. What else? How would you? Okay, very good. So these are the collaboration skills. So to build a good collaboration skills, the student must learn this one. Okay. Why I'm saying this to all of you? Because in the future, you will become teachers. Therefore, you need to develop these skills to your students. Okay. The second one is communication. What is communication? It doesn't only mean that you will call, you are going to text. That's not communication, right? That's not only the communication that we should know. When we say communication, it is expressing thorough our thoughts clearly, crisply, articulating opinions, communicating coherent instructions, motivating others through powerful speech. Yeah. Well, this is what I encountered for the past years that I am teaching students. I do believe that in your 3 to 12 classes, you often have group works, right?
Yes, sir.
And every group works, you experience that someone will have a conflict with the other members. Have you ever tried to experience that?
Yes.
Oh yeah, very good. So you think the reason why there's conflict, because of inability to articulate communications. That's the reason why communication is very important. And these are the things that we can do. Communicate using digital media and environment to support personal learning. And this is what I encountered before to the students. This is a modern classroom. When there is group work that they need to accomplish for a particular week, ano ginagawa ninyo sa klase ninyo kapag may papag-group work si teacher in terms of communication? Ano yung ini-initiate ninyo yung ginagawa kapag may group work kayo? Ibawa, mag-research kayo. Ibawa, one-seven yung research. Ano ginagawa ninyo sa grupo ninyo para papag-communicate properly?
Share thoughts.
Oh, you share thoughts. Pero what do you use to share your thoughts? What mediums do you use? What platforms do you use?
Social media,
particularly
Messenger.
Okay, you create group chats, very good. So communication using digital media is one of ways to build communication skills. Share information efficiently and effectively using appropriate digital media environment. Okay, but this is now my follow-up question. When you share files, resources in your group chat, what is the disadvantage? For example, one week, okay, I will share with you this week about our file for chapter 1. Yes, how about here? Natatapunan. Do you agree with me that using group chat, natatapunan yung mga So, ano kaya gagamitin natin para mas effective yung communication? That's our next question. Communicate thoughts, ideas clearly and effectively to different audiences using various media and formats. Okay. The next one is the creative thing. This is based on your Adobe creative trainings before our webinars. I guess that you learned that creativity does not only mean related to what? When we say creativity, we often associate it with what? It's arts. Very good. But the creativity does not always mean arts. When we say creativity, it's something that you can produce new, diverse, and unique ideas. Thinking creativity means looking at things at different perspectives, and that being restricted by rules, customs, or norms. I will give you an example. One of my students before, when I asked him to draw a circle, or a circle, he don't only draw a circle. He drew a clock, something out of the rules. But of course, that's not my rule. But if you try to look at its creativity, because he go beyond the rules that I mentioned. And these are the ways on how to build effective creative skills, use a wide range of idea creation technique, and what is the keyword there for idea creation technique for creative skills? It's what? On the screen. Brainstorming, very good. So create new and worthwhile ideas, both incremental and radical concepts. Elaborate, refine, analyze, and evaluate their own ideas in order to improve and maximize creative efforts. And act on creating ideas to make a tangible and useful contribution to the field in which innovation will occur. Okay, and lastly, as we go on, because I know that these are already part of the assignment that we had, critical thinking is the last of the courses. It involves logical thinking and reasoning, including skills such as memory. What are the skills that includes in the critical thinking?
Comparison.
Very good.
Classification.
Okay.
Classification.
Very good.
Battery.
Webbing, analogies, etc. etc. So what does the meaning for our students? These are the things or skills that we need to develop to your students in order for them to develop critical thinking skills. Okay. A while back, I said to you that creativity is not only delimited for arts. The same manner that critical thinking is not only delimited to what? To? Solving. Or particularly, what field is that? Mathematics. Very good. So, critical thinking can also be developed in other fields of specialization. So, moving on, this is actually the main content of our package in technology for teaching. We are going to present Google Docs. But let's go back to the big word natin kanina. This is what we are going to accomplish today. How might we use Google Docs to put the forces of 21st century learning of students? Okay. Let me walk you through how to use Google Docs. Are you familiar with My Drive? Or Google Drive?
Yes.
Are you familiar? Okay. The Google Doc is one of the products of Google Drive. You can access Google Docs inside the Google Drive. But if you are outside, pag nasa labas po tayo, have you ever encountered these 39 dots here? This one, when you open Google, have you ever encountered these 39 dots? The 9 dots rather.
Yes.
We call that one as the waffle. We call it waffle or app launcher. In the app launcher, you can create new products, you hover down, you can find the Google Docs. Okay. I want you to go to your own respective Google Drive. Then you can create here your own Google Docs. Okay. Before you go with your activity, let's try first how to use Google Docs so that we can apply the courses. The first thing that we need to do is to create template. Or you can create your document. By default, just click blank. And what will happen? It will direct you now to your own Google Docs. What's the title of my Google Docs? A title document. Okay, remember class. When you are creating Google Docs, make sure you rename the file. Because what will happen, it will become a title document. So let's try to make this like a sample Google Docs. softball. Before anything else, let's try to apply the four C's on how we can use this one. First, what is the first among the C's that I discuss? What's the first among the C's that I discuss? Anyone? Based on the PowerPoint about that, what is the first one? It's?
Collaboration.
Collaboration. Louder?
Collaboration.
Louder.
Collaboration.
Everybody?
Collaboration.
Again, so collaboration. Let me show you how we can use Google Docs in collaboration. Okay. First, did you already log in your Gmails? How about on this part?
Yes.
You log in already your Gmail? Okay. Now, let me know your Gmail accounts. The collaboration in the Google Docs, listen carefully. No, focus your eyes on millennial ears. The focus of Google Docs, you can interact at the same time in one file. At the same time. Pag nagtatype yung isa, at the same time yung iba, pwede mag-type in just one file. Paano yun? How can we collaborate? Okay? You notice there is a share option. Okay? When I will click share options, it will direct you to a new account, or a new pop-up. Look at that one. So what do you notice with our pop-up when I click share? What do you see?
The account that you want to...
Okay, what's the first one? The first word we hear is?
Share.
Louder?
Share.
Share, very good. Meaning to say, I can add someone here to share this document. So let's try to make fun with this document. Let me know your email address.
Liberato.
John Rafael Classified. Okay. When I click that one, automatically I can share this file. What is your account?
Chan,
this one. Ashumi and then you. Janita Joy. Hello? Janita. Joy at gmail.com. Is that yours? Janita Joy. What else? At gmail.com. Okay? How about you?
Angelo Tayamen.
06. Okay. And then?
Stanley Marie.
Before I will share it to Han, before you will share, let's try to walk through on the different roles. Pag i-share ko sa inyo to, meron kayong tatlong options. How are you going to share it? First, viewer. When you say viewer, you can just view the document. Commenter, they will just comment from the website. When we say editor, the editor now means that he has the full access of the Google Docs. And one more thing, we have here an explanation. Like for example, you only want to share this document for 1 month, or I just want to share this for 1 month only. Therefore, I can add explanation. But for now, what do you think will I assign to you if I want you to type on my document?
Anything.
Who says viewer? Who says commenter? How about editor? Okay, again, I repeat. If I want you to edit the document that I will share, so what are you going to? What role will I assign to you?
Editor.
Again, so editor. Now, you can add a simple message so that the person will not be shocked. Oh, what is this document? You can see that this is a blah, 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 blah. Now, if I will send, okay, share that. Where will that person see the notification of this file?
In your Gmail.
Okay, very good. I want you try to look on the file that I shared to you. Okay. How to I have already here two person who is accessing the file. How do I know that? Look at this one. Can you see here your profile pictures? Right? This is way. Okay, don't type yet. Okay, don't type yet. and there's no structure. Don't type yet. Let's wait for the others. Okay. Let me again know your email address. Can you look at the one? Jovita. Is it my spelling is correct? Joy. @gmail.com. You are already an admin for that. Let me go with it. Oh, don't type yet. Don't type in.
Thank you. Okay. Oh, you look serious. I just wanted to write your name. It's like bibliography already. Okay. Okay. Stop. Stop first. Listen to me carefully. That's 1 minute. That's 1 minute. You see, you can type at the same time. Do you agree with me? In real time, while you are typing, you can see the one of the output of your, the one that this editor also is typing. Now, okay, stop. No more, no more.
No more.
Stop. No more. Listen to me, then your ears. Now, another tip for communication. Another tip for communication. You know, here, for example, you are handling non-leaders. Non-leaders. You are handling non-leaders. Or those who have difficulty in spelling. Now, we have here what we call tool called voice typing. Okay. Go to tools, voice typing. Let's see what will happen here on the voice typing. Hello everyone, my name is JJ. I am happy to meet you all today. What did we do with the file? The voice typing, instead of typing on the keyboard, use that one. That is good for those who are difficult in typing. Okay. Now, if you are a language teacher, something, there are tendencies that students don't know the words that you presented here. Now, I will present to you the so-called extension called BOAT. Okay. So the extension BOAT. Let's click extension and then click add once. Let's click add once. Okay. I think that's just wait for us for a second. And then click with the word bold. Okay. I want to find the word bold. The bold is not functioning right now. Let's wait for later on because my internet is not working. Now, for example, I want you to comment on the output. Example, hypothetically, these are just output. I want you to comment here. Stop that one already. I want you already to comment hypothetically. This is the student outputs. This is a good word. For example, Jangoy, you want to comment something on the work of Mr. Liberato. So what am I going to do so that I can comment without typing here? It is what we are going to do. For example, this is the work of Jan Rafael. I will highlight that. And then what do you notice? We have here three. You can add emojis. Okay, you can add emojis. Like for example, you love the output, you can click hard. Okay. Or, for example, I want to go to Sperling's work. Now, I want to add my comment regarding the output. Just click add comments. So when you add comment, you mention the person. For example, I will mention Sperling. Sperling kindly capitalize bachelor. For example, you assign to this guy. Now, Sterling, do you have a notification? Okay, can you show me your notification? What it looks like? Can you describe it? Okay, I have a comment, capitalize. Now, I want you to capitalize now the Bachelor of Secondary Education. Very good. now. After you accomplish my comment, the next thing that you will do is to click the check mark on the comment. What will happen if you will click this one? Let me see. Okay, what happened when Sperling clicked the check mark?
Publish.
Nawala. Correct? Nawala. Why? Okay, very good. Because the suggestion or the comments were already incorporated. Now, commenting is just giving a general feature. What if you want exactly to edit? It's unethical to edit it without the approval of that person. So what you're going to do is just to suggest editing. So for example, I will click this one. The last one will be suggest editing. What will happen to the suggest editing? I will now suggest and I will now type here what I'm going to do. And I want to delete this part. So ano nangyari kung delete ko siya? Nawawala ba yung mga words? Yes or no? No. What happened to the words? Does it vanish? Oh, can you describe what happened to the word? Where's a line? Okay. Because, for example, I don't want this to be, I don't want this suggestion of my roommate, I can reject. But if I want, I can accept. Okay? Now, let's go now with another features of this, which I think you will love the other feature of this. There is an update of here that can promote creativity. Okay. How are we going to do that, right? You can do the insert file, insert, and then smart chips. Look at here. The purpose of smart chips, you can give hyperlinks. When we say hyperlink, for example, I want to share a file here about, for example, I will upload the file.
I am directing.
What do you observe? When you try to, yeah. For example, I will put my research study. What do you notice? The file name will be attached on the document, but when you click the file name, it can embed already the link. Okay? Aside from this one, you can also embed what we call dates. I'm referring to dates. Okay? So, dates here, you can have here calendar events, for example. Or you want to go with other one, people, you can mention people, etc. Okay? Now let's go to the drop-down menu. So the new drop-down, how are we going to do the new drop-down? Let me try. The purpose of new drop-down is to create new this one. For example, you have a progress report. For example, status report, status. And then you are going to have accomplish. What else? What choices do you have if you are referring to accomplish? Partially accomplish. Can you suggest more? What else? Status? Not yet done. Etc. Now, what we try to see. What happened when someone will click the accomplish, you can do accomplish, not yet done. Ang kagandahan nito, ganito, makikin kayo sa akin. Ang kagandahan nito, gawa tayo ng table. Sa table, chapter 1, and then chapter, and then the status, and then people, for example, people. Can you see what I'm typing here? Yes or no? Okay, very good. For example, on the chapter, I will pull chapter 1. And then in the status, we can implement here the drop-down menu, the drop-down. So the drop-down here, we can click the status. So what it will be their status? Is it partially accomplished? And the people, we can mention who are the people involved. Diba? Maganda ito kapag gusto mo, malaman kung sino talaga. So people involved, you can have here, quantitative. So every time as you go on with the file, you can have here this one format. Now, what you are going to do, I want you to create, okay, I want you to create your own Google Docs and try to imagine how are you going to use this instructional material to your specialization. Okay, so for the task for today, we will be having it by group, okay? So this one, I guess you are the math and science group, and you are the language group. So for your activity today, I want you to, this one, choose a topic in the K-12 curriculum guide and design an interactive instructional material of the chosen topic using Google Docs. Make sure that the materials promote 4 C's of 21st century. So I want you to brainstorm for the first 5 minutes and the remaining time, let's have the workshop. And time check, what's the time? What time is it? 4:15. Okay, 4:15. At 5:10, or no, 5:15, is it okay? 5:15. We will have the presentation of your output.
That's the time of our time.
So I want you to go to your room and then work on your Google Docs. Okay, question. How can you work without going around with your... Yes, Linda? Paano tayo mag-work na hindi tayo naglakad-tinda? Anong gagawin natin sa Google Docs natin to avoid compact? What feature of the Google Docs?
Sharing options.
Very good. It is the sharing options.
Okay, yeah. I will move on now.
That's nice. Who will be the one to decide who work on it? Who created the Google Docs? So you are going to create the Google Docs. Okay. What's the first thing that you need to do after you share? Okay, I will share to you what we created in my innovators program. Starting in the middle, I didn't have here. So in here, you can have interactive materials for the reason that there's a hyperlink. So if someone will click apply now, it will direct them to the link where they can apply. You can also have hyperlinks like this one. The word, when you click the word with blue fun color, you can create a hyperlink of that. So how did I do that one, the hyperlink? So here on the day, automatically the dates using the smart chips. And then I add homeworks. So how did I create insert URL? How did I do that one? Just go to the insert and then look for this one. The keychain. Insert it. Diba, nakahanap kayo ng YouTube video, then you replace yung thing. Tapos ano magiging true ba? For example, I will click this one, copy that one, and then paste it here. I will label it as 4C's instructional material. So when you click that one, it will have a red line. Okay. Do that one for last 20 minutes. You can converse with your group. Divide your group. What will be your task? Of images, how of you? Okay. question.
I don't know if there's a session there, I don't know.
that's also suggestions.
Guys, you know what is the beauty of Google Docs? There is an artificial intelligence that they can track what you want to write. Like for example, Angelo, you already have track, right? You can write the Google Docs. Okay, we are on track already. How many minutes more do we have? Do we have still time?
7 minutes.
Last 12 minutes. This moment you can already decide. Using the chat box. You can use the chat box.
Yes.
Finalize your word, last 6 minutes. Let me check if you're ready to share there. Okay. I already received the output of the language group.
Sorry. able to determine what shades i-identify lucky lang kung anong shades ang nasa row 1 or nasa first na
the first column.
I follow that.
Okay.
So, they just going to click here and pipili sila kung anong shape or anong pangalan ng shape ang nasa column 1. So, for example, that is circle.
Here, we use the third column to show real life examples. So, so that the students can go in the real life also. But again, congratulations everyone. For the comments and suggestions, I want to incorporate them and then upload your answers on the Canvas. Okay? So I will be opening an assignment in Canvas for you to upload the answers. By now, let's have the language group. Angelo, it's your turn. And the same manner, these two, three, I want you to say what is your favorite about the output and what are the things. Bring it on. How might we question. So, for your assignment,
I want you to improve your interactive materials based on our comments and suggestions and upload it on Canvas for your grade one, for your graded output. Okay? So again, thank you everyone for participating in our class. Have a nice day, everyone. Goodbye.
Thank you, sir.